Greetings, mortals, and welcome back to the blindness of the Dwarven. Kickstarter portal man. So when last we left off, we were fighting ogres, which have gone from having a full dozen, to having a minimum of 11. Now the reason that I am facing so many of them is because of the difficulty setting that I'm on.
Sure.
So on Path of Dan, you get the same number of enemies that you normally fight on hardest level. But hard difficulty mode as well. In addition to basically all their stats are boosted. This one seems to be...
I cannot keep up this pace. Wraiths.
Okay, so we're gonna just pop this guy on his butt if we can. So we're
Stand still.
Yikes. I'm out of abilities to use, unless I... Okay, so he is the one being attacked now.
What?
Then again, I guess it kind of is. Actually, yeah, it is very much bad.
Yeah.
Because that's getting split five ways. So, the amount of experience you get for killing enemies is near non-existent in this game. I do not have enough damage potential to do the strategy that I was trying to pull off there. What is this? Oh, it's an ogre druid. Just facing a swarm of ogres.
Yes. What?
Plus 11.
Yeah.
That's
yes.
Not what I like to see.
Yes.
Yes. What?
He wants to attack. This guy, this guy has a reach weapon. The thing with reach weapons in this game is that you still can only engage in melee combat in terms of, like, getting the attacks of opportunity if the target is, if you are in direct melee.
No problem.
So, what that means is that I can disengage from these guys as long as I have a reach weapon. They do not. the stack one for 58 points of damage. Jesus. That hurt.
This thing isn't doing the job.
Don't even slow it down!
Oops. I forgot. These things are actually able to engage multiple people in combat simultaneously. Okay, well, we're gonna just die here. Let's load this. By the way, yes, we have confirmed that from the lofty heights of having 12 ogres to their name, they now have substantially more than 12 ogres. Because we just found another 3 over there. Solidly in the 14 territory, and we still haven't seen everything that's gonna be here.
Wait, sail this mate!
4 here? So one of them's walked away now, and then we only have one left. Forward. We now have an attack. Oh, Jesus. Don't like that at all.
Following your lead.
Yes.
How may I help?
Sacre Bleu!
Sacre Bleu! That was close. Way too close for comfort. Oh jeez, it's still alive. Okay, speaking of way too close for comfort...
I think it may be time to strike up camp.
That thing was mid-swing with the killing blow. Oh my god. Get very light. So 3 hours, I think we'll be done with the restoration of that place.
Of course.
And then once we finish the restoration of that...
Yeah.
Head over there.
Wait, sail this mate.
Knocked him out again. I don't think for a very long period of time.
Sacre Bleu!
Sacre Bleu!
You can trust me.
This thing is only at half life.
What? lesson to be taught.
One more of the toast. And we still have more. We have an unlimited supply of ogres over here, it looks like. Actually hit this guy with a pillar of faith.
Lavara,
oh god. That was it. He wasn't knocked down. Okay, so we've got him prone for another one of science. So we've got 80% done. 2 hours to go. Actually, just getting up there will probably take 2 hours. Actually, you know what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cast Dispose Vulnerability on this guy. And have her knock him down. And charge. If he can't cast this, then charge.
Hey.
Eh?
Okay.
Yes.
So expose one more builds on seem to be a unique breed. I wonder if we could speak to them.
I cannot keep up this pace.
Sure.
Fly swarm with a decaying overhead, roving over its dead eyes and black jaws.
Hello? Hello?
Sort of interesting that he said that considering before he talked to the other one. That guy might be implying that I can get through here without killing them all. So maybe I can. Where's this girl? Oh. So we have an exit here. Leads back to the entrance. I'm gonna save the game. We're gonna pop upstairs. Pop to Cape. Well, this is gonna take 2 hours, which means that our inn will be done when we get there. And that'll be good. So houses and accessories for keeping it sufficient. lesser skill combat. As far as a Bailey. This seems to be something that we should definitely do. So we're gonna do this first. Upgrade? Why is he upgrade? I don't have to, like, manually go over there, do I? Pay them personally? We're starting to notice your hard work. I dare say we'll have more visitors shortly. Glad you decided to stay on, my lady. It's been difficult watching this place stumble into decay time and again. To see it restored is... I can imagine the great crowds, the petitioners, music, perhaps in the evening? Oh, I've gotten carried away, haven't I? Here's the reward. I want to pay you. How do I pay you? If I'm not paying them properly, then it's silly to have them. Number C. Let's see. I guess we're just gonna head out here now. Does this still work? No, water looks fine. Good. Let's take a look at what's going on in here. Do we now have actual people thing? So this place is still pretty trashed. But we now have access to the second level. So presumably in the second level we can actually see. There's a deer that rambles on beyond the house. Save this, and we're just going to on the other side of this curtain, looks down a tangled mess of overgrown hedges. So we're going to rest with no bonus, but we're resting in our own bed.
Eh?
Save the game. Downstairs. And see, the next thing in the building is another wall. Not the most useful thing in existence, to be sure. But it'll have to do for now. Now go to the third level.
Nice and quiet.
Nice and quiet. Not really. We don't have anybody with any action skills. Not terribly quiet, but... I'm gonna send him in.
Where is Sail? Miss Mate.
That grazed him for 33 points of damage. Holy crap. That graze did 50 damage. Yikes. That was terrifying. But we're not gonna. He's activating some attack again.
Wow. He's one shot.
Gotta take
off.
Better care of Ella. This thing isn't doing the job.
Holy crap, these ogres are crazy. I'm wondering. It seems pretty clear that
quickly
we're not going to be able to just take this entire place one after another. It's becoming abundantly clear that. Reach a point where the enemies are dramatically stronger than us.
Wait, sailors, mate!
Jesus. So much damage. Wow, okay, so he's basically dead. Seriously.
Curses! Sure.
These druids, man. Oh, whoop. Oh. I forgot about the multiple things now. The multiple people that they can have in.
Eh?
In combat. This set of enemies might just be too powerful for me right now. I'm tempted to go after the dragon, because the dragon is at the very least paired up with a bunch of weaklings. So that's gonna be relatively easier. But I think what I'm actually gonna do is I'm just gonna pop out of here. I think that we've cleared out two levels, which is pretty good, and we've now reached what is not quite a brick wall, but is pretty close. On the plus side, these ogres aren't going to be coming up anytime soon, and nothing else is going to be getting past them anytime soon either. So I don't think that we're going to be in too much danger of having anything that's terribly bad happen to us from this. So let's just continue on. We're going to go to the wooded plains, I guess. We are looking to get to where? Take 18 hours to get to the wooded plains.
Lay in low.
So first things first, check the top. Forest Lurker. So Forest Lurker here, I'm gonna try.
Wait.
Yes.
It's not frightened.
Move!
Hey. All right then.
So there's a forest lurker dead. 70 experience. For a second. The game seems to think that these forest lurkers are at least on par with the ogres. I tend to disagree. These ogres are a lot scarier than this. I say creature, not a creature.
Lay in low.
Actually a colony of like 100 plants. Pretty freaky and messed up. So we can collect this body here. So we have
Hi
this buddy here.
Stuck over it.
My eyes are peeled.
Hello.
Yeah, Andrea takes a lot of damage when she gets focused.
No problem.
Facing her, there isn't really much I can do to change that. See if I can knock her. Well,
how may I help?
What? How did it hit her from? What did it use? That, what? She's still
no
near
problem.
It. That is weird. I'm sure that is a bug, but he cannot hit here to this guy. He's big, he's not that big.
I'll see what I can find.
Oh, so how much more do we have? 1 day and 17 hours. I just don't feel comfortable not having a door over there. So over here we have some sort of beasties.
Hush, Itumak. We'll just wait a little longer.
A dwarven woman dressed in skins and hides leans against the road marker. Her face is turned down, her eyes darkened by a thick stripe of face paint. She's sharpening a bone arrow headed with a scrimshaw handled knife. Her attention, however, is focused on the bear figurine beneath her, between her feet. A large white furred fox standing at her heels looks at a
European. Easy, Itumak. It's not him. Short version? I'm looking for a very, very old friend. I'm not sure what skin he's wearing now, but I'll know him when I see him.
Number one.
That's what I heard. Of course, the man who told me so was carrying a staff he claimed was made from dragon bone, but I know Whitewood when I see it. That should have been my first clue, but I had to try something.
Two.
The long version. Here we go. I'm from an island to the far south called Nasitok. I came here looking for a village elder, a man we knew as Persok. I'm a hunter back home, so tracking someone wouldn't normally be a problem. But Persok's trail is cold, to say the least.
Five years. He died when I was still a young girl. Forgot to mention that part, didn't I? I'm looking for his latest reincarnation, which could be anyone. I'm gonna go with number one.
That about sums it up.
I'm gonna go number four. It's more of a campfire tale. I'm not quite ready to get into it. see. Nobody feels sort of interesting thing to say. We thus far haven't been in that situation yet, so just it's important.
So I keep reminding myself. Still, it would be nice if important duties came with clearer instructions.
She adjusts the figure on her trousers and raises it in a small flat palm. It's carved in the shape of a bear, smooth round. Polished odra is worn to a dull mat along its arched back to an ovoid haunches. A soft glow emanates from within.
Cute, isn't it? It belonged to Persok. Before he returned to the wheel, he left a splinter of his soul in it. Something to help us find him later. When I left Nasitok, it was completely dark inside. But as I've gotten closer to Persok, it's glowed steadily brighter. Since I've reached the Deerwood, however, it's gotten hard to read. Some days it flickers and goes dark. Others it shines nice and bright for a few hours. But most of the time it looks just like this. I've heard that one before. The whole reason I'm standing here is because some so-called watcher from Forkedvale told me he could take a look. For a few golden dukes, of course. I was on my way out of the Balmarsh when I heard talk of a traveling mystic who could supposedly see souls. I knew it was a long shot, but what did I have to lose? I went to see this fellow and gave him the Audra figurine. He made a big show of moaning and rolling his eyes, and after I'd given him 5 golden dukes to lift the shroud, he told me to seek the crossroads in the field between the wolf's lair and the twining trees.
He meant Twin Elms. I haven't been there yet, but I hear there's especially memorable trees. Wolf Lair is Divine's Bay. Interesting. Well, locals call the current wolf the Duke Wolfbrand.
He thought he was being vague, but I know the area well enough to recognize that he meant this place, right between Defiance Bay and Twin Elms. I had a bad taste in my mouth, but my coin was spent and I'd already left an arrow in his knapsack as a friendly warning. Told him I'd come back and leave him with another if it turned out he was giving me the runaround. I've been here a week now. Guess he had the last laugh after all.
Maybe with number one. Can't go with number one.
Why?
I'm gonna go with number one.
You expect me to believe that? After the story I just told you?
I'm gonna go with number two.
Fine. But if you try to run, just remember that my arrows are faster.
I mean, you know, this is the kind of thing where it's like, if you can just help someone so easily, if possible, I don't know if I can, you might as well just do it. Sorry, I didn't make the description. So, she hands you the figurine, her chapped knuckles grazing your hand. She watches you examine it, wary but curious. You raise the Audra Bear, turning it in the light. As your eyes catch a tiny glinting scratch, the scenery around you melts away. You're standing on a cliff overlooking the water, seeing through eyes that aren't your own. You catch a musk of bears amidst the French scent of vegetation, your heart beats a little faster. You'll have to watch your step up here. You look down just long enough to see the sharp, pale cliffs drop into the water hundreds of feet below you. Number three. Breathing deeply, you smell salt in the air. Wherever you're standing, wherever Persok is standing, it must be near the ocean, not a lake. Two. I'm gonna go with number one, I guess.
What are you talking about? What just happened?
If you'd seen the way she stares at dead things, you'd know she's serious.
You realize I've got no coin to give you, even if I did believe you.
I'm gonna go with number one. Why not?
And if this is your idea of a joke, you may be stuck with me for a while. Lead the way.
We now have a full party. So, what does the animal companion do?
I'm here.
Let's take a look. So she has a very similar amount of experience to what we do. And let's take a look. Animal companion combat bonuses, plus 3 accuracy, 12% extra damage, and 5% extra damage. I don't know how the animal companion works, really. Let's take a look at her now. Let's take a look at what her skills are. So she has 9 survival and 4 stealth. 4 stealth is the highest in the party, actually. 9 survival is definitely the highest in the party. She has Hunter's Instinct, so she does extra damage against wilders and primordials. Now, she is an archer, it looks like. She has this dual wield stuff that she can do. Could try it out.
Yeah.
It's worth a shot.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
Take a look here. That is a lot of lions. So let's see if we can... hold up 7.
Waves. Ailments. Mating.
That is a lot of lions. Crap. That is so many lions.
Hey.
Okay, so we're now engaged in combat. Let's see. Whoa, what the heck is that?
Hi?
For some reason, he wasn't actually getting people engaged in combat. I don't know what it was, but when they got next to him, he wasn't getting engaged. So that was very bad, and we're just going to reload because now it's just a giant clusterfuck. It shouldn't be because we did have
a
good position. So I think I'm going to fight them here.
Hey.
Pop the sound.
What?
What, really? Okay, they're gonna just line up for me.
I shot.
These ones are in for a while.
Following you.
Oh.
Curse this!
Yeah, I don't know. Nope. I don't want him attacking because he tends to cause he's gonna fight this one. So we are out of knockdowns. Actually, everybody's gonna fight this one. What the hell just happened?
Yeah.
Hey. So. What is this wounding shot? As he or she would with fleeing prey, the hunter aims for a spot that will slow the cowboy having the ambulance time. Seriously, fatigued. Oh my god.
Aren't
you supposed to be some sort of like hunter? Sad.
White flame and sound.
Graves are roughly chiseled into the stone. They grasp it on his beloved moon like curling fingers. Earth harvest. Burning lash. And GR bypass.
I'm here.
Let's take a look. She's got already. She's got a normal fine hatchet. It's gonna give this to him. No, I'm actually not. Maybe I will. Let's take a look at what else we can put on this. Put accurate on it. We need more Pilgrim's Crown for that. Okay, so we're gonna just do that. We're gonna give her a minor protection. On the plus side, I have just confirmed that I can use the special abilities with daggers. The dagger. It's gonna jump this area. Whoa. Hello.
Me.
Nice and quiet.
So that's one pack of lions dealt with. I'm not going to bother talking to these people because they supposedly can have spoilers. So tucked into the flap of this bedroll is a relic of some kind, a small conch shell strung with seaweed. So, camp supplies that currently this person doesn't mind me seeing. I didn't actually take them because I can't have more than two stored at a time. Now, I still haven't tracked down those beasties from the start again. Sparrow's nest is tucked between two angles. Whoa, okay, so there's a giant pack of those here. Really, really big pack of those. This is Forest Troll. Okay, so let's swap over to our movement speed increasing. So they are definitely casting spells. So she turned her back on us, which was probably a bad idea.
This thing is doing the job.
Wow, 62 is very good.
Some fermented caribou milk would hit the spot right now.
Let's see what lies this way.
Worthy name of Mansawu.
That is a lot of enemies. Okay, so let's just try and knock her over.
Can't get a good shot with this.
Yes? Of course.
Sagani killed. So I guess we should probably. Who wins?
Sure.
One step closer. Come
on.
Looks like she's a Another one bites the dust. That is a lot of them. Cluster. Just beating on them from all sides. Just kidding. So many people. I like it. I like it a lot. They were gonna save this.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
Slow and silent.
Whoa, she just summoned something. A rain blight.
Yes?
So we need to get her dead ASAP so that we can do anything. Damage is necessary. Because the blights, or sorry, the summoned creatures, as we found out when we were fighting the shadows, they disappear when you destroy the thing that summoned them. Trap triggered? Oh, she triggered. She triggered that trap.
Right.
Who's this?
What?
Durant's.
If it makes you rest easy.
They just take explosive damage from it?
I cannot keep up this pace.
Oh, come on. It didn't die, it got desummoned. Well, that's crap.
Eh?
Oh well. One more down. Okay, so
hi.
Holy crap, 87%? This is just one pack.
Huh!
Okay, so the first girl's dead. Take out my contacts soon. So, we are almost done with this place.
Slow and silent.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
So we can now go to the searing, which we call it. That is the exact name. Wine dregs swirl around the bottom of the clay jar. Push of iron. Okay, so I think that there were some enemies up here. Some of those things. 1 day, 9 hours.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
We made an ensemble.
Funny watching them walk behind the trolls.
We made an ensemble.
These trolls are hard to knock down. So this area will definitely finish off these things, bestiary entry. That's a problem. I just re-aggro the entire pack. So what we're going to do is we're going to cast this, try to knock over as many of them as possible with it. And we're going to cast another one over here. So I'm gonna have her just attack this guy and hopefully knock him over. Wow, that didn't actually knock anybody over.
Listen to
Sunrock.
Yes?
What? Damn it.
That's not good. I am going to... make an idiot. I'm gonna try and just... oh wow, actually this thing's really low. Okay, so there we go. Aldrea finished off hers. She's flanking this one, so she can kill that one off. And now we can just sort of wipe the floor with this one. Whew. And that's a wrap.
Some fermented caribou milk would hit the spot right now.
I'm sure it would.
Eh?
Okay, so we finished up this area. We've killed everything in it. We have 2 minutes left in the stream, and we have these people falling over from exhaustion because they are noobs. I'm kind of wondering, like, how often does this game expect you to rest? If you have anyone in your party who doesn't have at least 3 athletics, because the amount of the speed with which these people just become fatigued is crazy to me. I think we're gonna go to. One day and 8 hours to make our next building. So take 8 hours. Do I want to go to Searing Falls? Do I want to go to Mad Hammer Bridge? I'm kind of tempted to go over to this place because I have no idea what this place is. Oh, this is Defiance Bay. Oh, so Defiance Bay is a big city. Well, that doesn't make any sense at all. Why did the thing suggest that I needed? Give me a second. I need to check this. Why would I need to go east? Cade Noir to get to Defiance Bay, which is this city right here. Because I had to get through the Black Meadow to get to Mad Hammer Bridge and to Cade Noir, which Mad Hammer Bridge leads straight here, I think. Oh! No, it was saying that this bridge is out? Is that what they said?
Well, yeah.
If that bridge is out, we definitely need to go here. So we're going to pop over here. One day, 22 hours. 18 hours. One day, 10 hours. Okay, we're gonna go to here. Because we're just sort of going around. There's... time is up. Western Barbican construction complete. Okay, so what else do we need? We need... Maybe you get the south and west curtain. Well, look at that, plus four. Pretty sexy. I don't think that's what we want, though. So... I think that the Warden's Lodge is probably our best bet. That seems like a good bet. It's just to get that, it gets plus two to each. And it'll be good. So go to Mad Hammer Bridge. Oh, my alarm just went off, didn't it? Okay, so we just finished up another one of our buildings. We have a fatigued party, so we're going to have to rest them very shortly. We're actually right next to our place, so maybe we should just... do that. Anyway, that's going to be the end of the stream for tonight, so thank you everyone for watching, and I'll see you again next time.